Hello and thank you for taking a look at the WooCommerce Products Wizard. In this video we are going to set up the dynamically generated product thumbnail from the selected products in your wizard. To do so we need to have a ready to work wizard. So let's use this one. Here we can see it on a page. As you can see, it allows to create a customized bike. It has a few steps to choose the main bicycle parts. We are going to show how the ready customer's bike will look like. Before we start, let me show you the images we will use to generate the thumbnail. Here are a few images in the media library. All of them are PNG files with a transparent background, to make covering each other much easier. So first of all, I'm gonna take the special option to make the dynamic thumbnail generation on. After this we need to prepare an image canvas. Firstly, define the canvas width and height. I'm going to use a standard image ratio in pixels. Our canvas have automatically changed according to the new size. Now place the first canvas area to be used for presenting a bike frame. Click on the add item button to add a new area. Here is the total number of canvas areas presented, and a button to remove them all at once. Now click the gear button in the center of the area to see the area settings modal. In this modal, you can find a couple of buttons to open the next or the previous area settings modal. They will help you to jump between them easier. The next field allows to set the area's z-index value. You can move the area upper or lower on the canvas. Then bigger the value, then upper the area is placed. We will use it a bit later. The next important setting of the area is its name. This is necessary to define some name to fill this area with an image lately. In our case, let's call it frame. That area will present the selected frame image. To make the area positioning easier, let's select any frame image using the setting. I'm going to save the current area settings to see what we have at the moment. Here is our area with the applied image. We need to resize and place the area in a better place to have the correct bicycle view. The size and placement settings of the area are changed accordingly. Let's go further and create a new area. We'll call it wheel and choose a random wheel image. So I believe it should be somewhere here. Now let's just copy this wheel to have a couple. You might notice the areas can have the similar names. We'll see how it works a bit later. Now I'm going to add one area for a bike saddle and one area for handlebars. And it's done. Let's also add a small area, just for a better bike view. We don't need to define its name as it will be static. There will be only an image of a gear. Now everything looks pretty fine. We can try it from the public side. Here we can see our thumbnail in the sidebar looking the same as we did it, and it's already an usual file. You can open or save it as usual, but we haven't selected any frame wheel saddle or handlebars yet, but they are already presented. I'd want the bike parts will appear one by one, only then we select an appropriate product. To change this behavior, let's back to the admin part and just remove the applied area images. We'll keep only the gear image cause it will not be changed. So let's go now to our frames first. All of these are variable products with three different colors to select. So we will present an appropriate image for each variation. Here you can find the thumbnail area setting group. There can be one or more setting rows. For now one row is enough. So let's open the settings modal. The main two settings here are the area name and image to apply above the area. For this specific frame and variation I want to apply this image. I select it and now want it will be placed above the frame thumbnail area. So I'll type frame in the area name setting. And now then this product variation will be in the cart. The area setting will be applied. Now I'm gonna do the same for the other two variations. Type frame in the area name setting and select an appropriate image for it. We're done with this product, so let's save it and handle the others. It will be absolutely the same workflow, so let's don't stop a lot on it. Let's check how it works with the wizard. I'm selecting a product variation, and here we can see the kit thumbnail is regenerated accordingly. Works well, doesn't it? Let's continue to create our dynamic thumbnail. The next step of our wizard is wheels. They are variable products also, but the properties they have are not important for the product view. so I'm going to use the Comment Product Settings group instead of the Each Variation setting. For this wheel, that image will be used. Don't forget to define the area name, that will be wheel. Then I save the changes and do the same operation with all other wheel products. The wizard will check the product variation level first. If there is no thumbnail setting defined, it will try the product level. You can achieve more flexibility using such behavior. Let's check the results again, as we have two areas named wheel. Both of them are replaced by an appropriate image. That works super again. So the next step to visualize will be handlebars. All of the handlebar products look pretty similar, so there is only one image to present them. To make it easier, let's open the handlebars category setting. Here we found the familiar settings group. On a category level, it will be applied while any product from this category is in the wizard cart. It's done and here it is. When any handlebar is in the wizard's cart, we see it as a part of our bike. The last step to handle is saddle. These products are variable and using the color attribute, as all saddles also look pretty similar and differ only by a color, so we'll use only two saddles images, one per each color. Here is our saddle color attribute values. On the attribute edit page there are the same settings to be changed. The thumbnail area name should be saddle. The appropriate image is selected also. When both attribute values are done, we could try it in the wizard. As you can see, the thumbnail has the appropriate saddle color, whatever product is added to cart. But we have a small issue with one of the frames, namely this one. It has a bit different shape, so the saddle is placed wrong on the canvas. How can we fix this issue? Pretty simple. Let's return to the wizard admin part. Now I'll show you a couple of ways to solve the issue. The first one is to clone and give a different name to a saddle's area. Let's call it low saddle. I'm using the frame and saddle images just to place the area appropriately. Now we have a couple of saddle's areas with different names. Then I'm going to modify the saddle color attribute values again. Here is the setting we already have. I'll set the availability rules for the row to work only when our specific frame is not in the cart. Save it and clone the settings row. For this new row, I'm going to change the name setting to low saddle and change the availability rule to work only when the frame in the cart. According to these rules, only one of these rows will work at the moment. Let's repeat the same for another attribute and check the results. And all's good now. Only one area is covered by an image and it fits the current frame shape. And here is another way to solve the issue. Let me quickly revert the attribute settings back as they were before, and rename the cloned saddle area. Now what we will do with them, I want one of them will be available for the low frame and the second of the others. To do so I'll set the area's availability rule for the first area, available when the frame is in the cart, and for the second, then the frame is not in the cart. Let's save the changes and try this. And here it is, it works exactly how we want it. Now what we can do with the generated thumbnail, there is a special shortcode to get the generated thumbnail link. It will help if you need to show the thumbnail in another place. For example, you can output it on any step description or the results PDF file. Here is a bonus for you. I'm going to add a new area here and call it logo. Then I will add a special wizard shortcode into a step description to output the file select input. You can find more information about it in the plugin documentation. That shortcode will have the name attribute equal to logo, the same as the new area titled, and there will be the attribute to accept only image files to be chosen. Here how it looks like. And here is the trick. Open the step with the file input, choose an image file from your device, and head over. Here is our image applied above the logo area we've just created. The wizard binds the thumbnail area with the file input by the name. You can use this trick to create composite products with a custom print or similar. Well, that wraps it up. You've just built a dynamically generated thumbnail to present the selected products for a WooCommerce Products Wizard. Now you know how to provide more individual and better service to sell your composite products. If you've got any questions, please reference the online documentation that's available on the plugin site, check the frequently asked questions, or get in touch via the support section. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope you have a good time. Take care.